If you are a Lightroom user looking for more creative options and precise control when editing portraits, you need to know about the Nik Collection. Today we're focusing on Color Efex Pro for color and tone, Silver Efex Pro for gorgeous black and whites, and PreSharpener and Sharpener Output for tack sharp details, all directly within your Lightroom workflow. And stick around to the end of the video to unlock an exclusive discount code. Nik 7 Collection has their own standalone applications. If you're working on Lightroom, it is quite easy to integrate Nik Collection in the workflow too. I have here a beautiful portrait opened in Lightroom. To access Nik plugins, go to the photo menu, edit in, and here you can find the Nik Collection. I'm gonna here start with the Nik 7 color effects. In the next window, check the first option for a non-destructive editing workflow, and also make sure the file format selected is TIFF and click on edit. This opens the image in Nik Color Efex. On the left, you can find categories. Under that, there are presets and filters. Each category has their own preset, and each preset is customized with already tuned filters. Clicking on a preset, you can find the filters associated with it on the right side. There is a portrait category too. Instead of going to filters and tuning everything manually, presets are the way to go, which makes it easier. Yeah, you get this classic vintage look. You can see in the filters how the temperature sliders are more on the warmer side. I'm going to select all Nik category and we'll see if any of the presets is a good starting point for me. Fall preset looks really good here with autumn colors. You can see on the right, it has a couple of filters applied. On top of these, you can select any of the filters here too. What if I apply another skylight filter on top of this? The image looks more vibrant now. You can compare the before and after by clicking on the buttons at the top. You have also the toggle to enable or disable the filter to see the before and after the filter is applied. Here on this Indian summer filter, you can control the intensity of the filter with the opacity slider. Controlling the strength of the skylight filter here, you have the option to add control points for local adjustments. For example, adding a control point and enabling the mask. You can see which areas are affected where the skylight filter is applied. You can fine-tune the mask with the luminance slider, tuning chrominance too. I'm here looking for this particular filter to be affecting mainly the skin tones. Now, this particular filter is mainly applied on the face with the control point we created now. You can see the before and after by toggling the visibility of the control point. Adding a vignette filter too. You can save this as a preset too. Name it and you can find this in the custom category for you to access it anytime. If you apply this, you go back to Lightroom with all these filters saved. Portraits can look stunning in black and white too. Opening this portrait in Silver Efex. This is the neutral look which is applied by default. The presets on the left to make it easy as a starting point. Other than the basic exposure sliders, you can play with the colors too. You have the color filter. Clicking on any of these makes that particular color from the original colored image more bright and the opposite colors dark. If you want more control of these, you have the sensitivity filter. The red and the yellow sliders affects the skin tones, tuning them to get the right brightness on the face. You can see the areas which are affected by tuning the cyans. Making it more dark gives a good contrast here. Not much pure blues in the image. Violet certainly affects the clothes here, making these more darker. You can see how you can control the contrast just playing with the color sliders. With the control points to selectively make local adjustments on the eyes here. Trying here to pop them a bit. Controlling the mask of the control points here. You can see the before and after for a striking change in the looks. I did make one more edit in Silver Efex on this striking portrait of an old woman. Was trying here for a dragon look. You have this film roll options to choose. These are some classic Kodak looks here, which adds that classic grain to the image to look gritty. There is also a separate film grain options to choose. Some overlay color tones too. I did make few local adjustments on this and got this gritty dragon effect on this. Ton of filters to customize the look you are going for. Now for the advanced sharpener plugins. There are two here, PreSharpener and Sharpener Output. As the name suggests, PreSharpener is applied before any edits are made. On this portrait, there's some room to pop the finer details a bit more, so opening the PreSharpener plugin. Already by default, sharpening is applied, as you can see in the tuned sliders, tuning it further to my liking. I don't need to have this globally, so we'll add control points to limit it to around this area. We'll tune the luminance and chrominance sliders to fine-tune the mask here. You can see now the sharpening is active only on this area. I will add a couple more control points on the eyes to get some subtle pop in there. After these edits, I will switch to color effects to change the look a bit. We'll try some presets here from the portrait category. This looks good but a bit too shiny, so we'll reduce the glow a bit. Also the brightness on the highlights. Reducing the intensity of the filter here to make the effect more subtle. Now comes the important part, especially if you want to print this. Now switching to Sharpener Output. You can see the options here. You can view how the sharpening looks on different mediums starting with digital displays. If you want to print this out on inkjet printer and you have the viewing distance and the particular paper type and the resolution selected, this is how it will look on those. You can preview here on your display on how this will look in different mediums. For example, on inkjet printers, this is the output you may get and the sharpening may seem too overbearing. You can now control it by reducing the sharpening strength and play with structure, local contrast and focus sliders to get the look you want when printed on inkjet printers. You have different options to tune the sharpening accordingly with different resolutions. If you are happy with the sharpening output for this particular medium, you can save it as a preset and access it anytime from the custom category. Why not try these yourselves? You can get 15% off of any software with this exclusive code or try it for free. No credit card required. More info in the video description. See you all in my next video. Thanks for watching.